birthday. I wasn't going to be a child anymore. When I was in fifth grade, I fell off the monkey bars and broke my arm, but the school nurse told me I'd only bruised it.
Why is it I get older and older and I don't get any more mature?
This is 17.
This is 50. As a young dancer, I was never concerned about my weight. But to tell you the truth, I should have been, because back then I was a little heavy. You know, when I first realized I was getting older, I was looking at my hands and my knuckles reminded me of my mother's.
I've always been short, so my mother said she'd put me on a rack and stretch me.
When I went to the hospital to have my arms set, the doctor said that they ought to fire the school nurse for accomplice.
Later on, when I mentioned that at home, my kids would always say, "But Mom, you're not fat." And I'd say, "I'm not fat for a mom, not fat for a dancer." Then one summer, I had a particularly energetic residency teaching, a lot of rehearsing, a couple of performances. And when I got back into the city that fall, everybody said, Claudia, you look terrific. You lost a lot of weight this summer. One day I was in the dressing room with Dale Thompson, and she said to me, Claudia, you really did lose a lot of weight this summer. And I said, well, maybe I did. I didn't try or anything. It just kind of happened. Maybe I have cancer. And I did.
Oh. Yeah.
Well, I got through it. I got through the surgery. I got through the chemotherapy. Actually, we broke off chemo a little early because we found a brain tumor. Now, everybody thought that was a metastasis, which would have been curtains for me, and I did spend a few morbid days over it. I got myself into New York Hospital for a week of testing. Some of the most grisly tests invented by man. And as the week wore on and the results of the test came through, it seemed more and more clear that I did not have cancer, but I had an entirely different kind of tumor, something that's always benign. Well, it had to come out anyway, but they sent me home for the weekend and scheduled surgery for the next week. Howard came to get me, and as we went home, I had the most extraordinary experience. My enormous relief was transformed into the kinesthetic sensation of floating. I sat high above the seat of the car. When we got home, I walked high above the earth. It was an amazing feeling.
My body is round and womanly. It's not what I would have asked for. That's too bad, right? My body is a limitation. Things are expected of you. You have to watch where you walk and how you walk, or the guys on the street will say things. Although I suppose they would anyway. People ask me what I'm going to major in college. I tell them I'm going to be a nun. Oh. I like the idea of being a nun. Nothing is expected of nuns. Nuns are pure. They're sacred. Married to God in their black robes. First time a guy touched me, it's like he was touching someone else's body. I was just looking down on it, and I didn't want it. I didn't want the whole thing. What I like about dancing, just me, and no one else. But I like being touched in my dance, because that's pure and safe. So if dancing doesn't work out, I can always become a nun. Sick of hearing this question. Yes, I do want to have a child. Forget about the fact it reminds me of my age. No big deal, I have no partner and my biological clock is just ticking away. So, What are my alternatives? One, I could adopt. No. Two, my sister had an idea. She said, why don't we find some nice man who would be willing to be the surrogate father for both of our kids? No. But my mom had the best idea. She said, Kathleen, why don't you move to Alaska? I hear there are huge amounts of men in Alaska. Great idea, Mom!
Ladies, don't you think that arms are really very feminine?
I think it depends on your arms, Claudia.
I have the arms of a chimpanzee.
I love your arms. I like my hip sockets because I have the hip sockets of a yogi. I always liken myself to Cousin It.
Who is that?
Of the Adams family? I see the resemblance.
This is life, and this is the life. No one's here, and not my brother. He just loves to tease me. He's 3 years younger than me, and almost as tall as me. Plus, he gets his kicks saying how he's so good at sports. And I'm so lousy at them. He says, ha ha, Kyra, in 2 years, I'll be just as tall as you. Which is very disappointing, because what if in 2 years, I've already stopped growing? Well, he'll be 5'10", like my father. I'll be 5'1", like my mother. And there's nothing I can do about it. Last time I went to a family party with him, all of the relatives kept remarking about how tall he was getting, but they didn't say anything to me. I felt like I was shrinking into my shoes. Well, I don't care. Next time I go to a party, I'll wear high heels. We're all the same size when you turn out the light.